Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Camry and we are back with another vlog. And I am so excited, and I know you guys are too, because this is a highly requested vlog that so many people have been asking me about. So many people have been wanting me to get in tune with. I did an Instagram poll in reference to this, and I also did an Instagram questionnaire for people to drop questions below on things they wanted to ask me in this vlog. And the majority of the questions was business questions. So guess what? We're gonna be answering all those business questions. I got my little notey. I wrote all the questions down in this book, and let's get started, y'all. Oh wait. If you don't know who I am, my name is Camry. I am the owner of The Foreign Experience. I'm a mom and everything. You know, I wear so many hats, you guys. I do everything. So yes, guys, if you don't know me, get to know me. Like and subscribe to this channel. And let's get into it, girl, because we're going on a journey. And the most of our journey, we're going to learn how to make money, and we're going to learn how to spend money on the right stuff. So let's go. Let's get into it. Okay, let's see what we have. Let's see. First question was, let's see. Okay, got it. Okay, let me try to go in order. Okay, so the first question is, what was you doing before you became an entrepreneur, and what made you start a business? So before I became an entrepreneur, I worked at TGI Fridays as a host. It was one of my first jobs. I was 16 years old, and I was on the edge of getting fired for chewing gum. So I went on and started working at another job, and later down the line I got another job after that. And with my last job, I was currently working at Walmart. I was working at Walmart, and that was actually the job where I saved up my money and bought my first car. So when I was working at Walmart, I never forget, I was talking to a girl. I was always in tune with makeup and stuff like that. I was talking to a girl and we started talking about lashes, and I love lashes. That's what I spend all my check on. I used to spend my whole check on makeup out of the cosmetic section at Walmart and things of that nature. So I decided to like sell lashes. Like, people were like, where you get your lashes from? Girl, those lashes are cute. So I started selling lashes. I never forget, I started selling mink eyelashes, and I started like this. The name of my company was called Lash by KW. I made my little logo on Microsoft. I cut it out and I put it on these little boxes from Hobby Lobby. I also put the lashes on Twitter. They blew up. Remind you, this is back in 2016, so this is like really before it got as popular as it is now. And it kind of blew up. The business was doing good. I noticed that I had a lot of out of state people that followed me who was interested in the lashes at the time. So I went in and I made a website. It was called Mink Eyelashes, and that was the name of my website. It was one of my first websites. I built it on Shopify. And y'all, it was really basic. It just had the name of my company there, and it just had the lashes posted on there, and it was like behind a glitter background I bought from Hobby Lobby. So that's how I started off. That was one of my first businesses, and I can say like business was going good. Like, I was doing girls' lashes in the girls' bathroom in high school. I was putting them on, and I never forget, I spent like $100 on a lash extension kit. Like, I was like, okay, I want to do lash extensions. Like, I want it to be more in depth. Like, I'm always the person who always strive to do more, and that's like one of my biggest issues right now to this day. Like, I'm always finding myself trying to figure out how I can do more. What can I do more? What can I do? What could I have done different? So I've always been that girl. So I started trying to do lash extensions. I bought my first little kit off of eBay, didn't know a thing about it. All I knew is that I used to get my lash extensions done. After I started selling lashes, I started getting eyelash extensions done. And that's where it went. So remind you guys, I'm like 16 years old. So I never forget, I was in this program. I was going into my 11th grade year in high school, 11th, and I started this program called Co-op. I'm not sure if a lot of y'all are familiar with that. I started this program called Co-op, and in this program, basically, you were able to leave school and go to work and get credit for it. So I was lucky enough to get a job in oil and gas. That's how I started working off in oil and gas. I got certified to be administrative assistant. So I was an administrative assistant in an oil and gas company, the corporate office, and I worked there. And as I started to work there, I was just like, I wanted to do something a little more than just sell lashes. Like, the lash business was going good, but I had started to find myself getting into crazy hair colors, getting into hair. I loved hair, and anybody that knows me knows that. And I used to spend, before I started selling hair, I used to buy hair from Cash Doll, best friend, Kendra. And I started buying hair from her. And so many people used to be like, where do you get your hair from? Where do you get your hair from? I love your hair. So boom, guess what? I'm like, how about I start my own hair company? I was really afraid in the beginning, because I'm like, okay, selling lashes to girls for $10 is one thing, but trying to get somebody to buy something that costs $200 and $300 is absolutely another thing. So I never forget, I planned the entire summer. I was working. I was like, I'm gonna launch my business. I had wrote down so many goals. I was like, I'm gonna have this photo shoot, I'm gonna do all this. Like, I had planned everything out. I was like, saying, I'm not even worried about prom. I just want to be successful in my business. I just wanted to take that to the next level, because I already knew that working wasn't for me. And like I said in my previous video, I always wanted to be a teacher, but when I figured out how much teachers made, I always knew that wasn't what I didn't want to go into that industry, because I knew I wouldn't be satisfied with the pay. And like I told you in these vlogs, I'm going to teach you how to make money, and we're going to learn how to spend money. And best believe, I like spending money, but I like making money as well as I like spending it. So moving on, so I planned out the whole summer, and I can say one of my advice would be to a lot of girls that I see a lot of entrepreneurs doing. I'm gonna just give this quick little tip, this quick little advice. I was that girl who went out and I bought wigs, I got the wigs customized, I had a photo shoot, I ordered all the matching outfits and stuff like that. And I can say that one thing that I want entrepreneurs to know, that I wish I would have knew before I started, was do not go out your way spending so much money in the beginning of your business. Don't go out your way spending so much money into inventory and into all the things that don't matter. If it can't make you money, don't do it, especially in business. Don't spend it if it's not a guarantee that it's going to make you money. And I was that girl who went out and did a photo shoot. And I see a lot of people, a lot of entrepreneurs that start in businesses now, they go out and they, you know, have these extravagant photo shoots, you know, stuff like that. They was like, oh, I have to have a photo shoot, I have to have a website. And I'm gonna be honest, don't spend all that money. Let me say this, don't spend all that money on a website. Don't spend all that money on a photo shoot, because those are things that's not important. Number one rule in business that's important is to make money. That's the biggest thing. Don't get me wrong, in business, it's not always about making money. You're gonna take a lot of losses, you're gonna take a lot of L's. But starting off, when you come from nothing, you don't have a strong support system, you don't have family, or you don't have the funds, you don't have a rich, I'm that girl who didn't have a rich boyfriend, no rich parents. I'm the girl who got it out the mud. I worked for that money that I had. And if you're that girl too, don't spend your money on that. Invest your money into marketing. Marketing is the number one thing that you need to invest all your money into. It's a difference between marketing and branding, so don't get me wrong with that. Don't spend all your money into marketing. It can wait. I'm telling you, it can wait. Learn how to make your business work for you. Learn how to make money. And then when your business start making money, you invest into all those other things. So to those entrepreneurs out there that feel like you have to have a website that's gonna generate your sales, no. Because 9 times out of 10, a lot of your sales are not gonna be online. Especially if you're a small business and you start small and no one knows who you are. Just being realistic, half of the time, people don't even know who you are. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody is not blessed with followers, and believe that you can have followers and not turn neither not one of those followers into a dollar. So don't focus on spending so much money into your business. Learn how to generate. We have to learn how to get out here, and you have to think, nowadays in time, everything generates around social media, but you also have to have that footwork. You have to understand how to get out here and hustle and connect and communicate with people in order to buy your product, because it's a million girls selling hair, it's a million girls selling lashes, a million girls doing everything. You have to do what sets you apart and what's best for you and your company. So moving backwards, so yeah, I started my company. Write that down. The stuff that I just said, write it down. It's a pointer. Stuff I said about my company. I was that girl. So I also had one of my classmates draw my logo. I will never forget. She drew my logo. Then I later took it out to a graphic designer and had my graphic designer to implement the color into it. The name of my business at the time was called Foreign Girls Hair Collection. I started this business December 2016. I started off with Foreign Girls Hair Collection, that later rebranded to The Foreign Experience in 2019. I rebranded my company to The Foreign Experience, which I had to literally start from scratch because my business page ended up getting deleted. Don't know why, but Foreign Girls Hair Collection got deleted. And when it got deleted, I was just like, you know what, it's just a time that I take this moment to rebrand my company, rebrand everything that we've been through over the years, and just give a fresh new start, give a totally different experience with my hair company. And that's the reason why I end up calling it The Foreign Experience, because The Foreign Girls Hair Collection, anything foreign will always have a place in my heart. So I couldn't just throw my baby out. I just wanted to give you guys The Foreign Experience. So that's how I started my business. And I started my business because I know there's gonna be a question, how much did you start your business? At the time, my budget I think was $400. That's when hair was dirt cheap back then. Now the hair industry is so oversaturated that vendors are even going outrageous with the prices of selling hair. So I think I spent like $200 on $100 or $200 on the hair or whatever. And I had a photographer, she only charged $100 or whatnot. And yeah, it was really simple or whatnot like that. I didn't even spend a lot at the time. I got like a whole branding package for like $100 for my logos, my business cards, my tags, my everything. Y'all, now stuff is so expensive. Oh my god. But this is the world that we live in. So moving on, I hope that answered all your questions. If I miss anything, I'll try to add it at the end, or I just leave your questions below and I'll answer them. Okay, okay, I have okay, how did you face your fears when it came down to starting your business? Okay, so I really started my business, I had no guidance or direction to what I was doing. I just jumped out and I jumped in and just knew for what I just went for what I knew. And I kind of got over my fears. Some of my fears was not making people happy, people not being satisfied with the service or the product that you offer. Those are some of my fears. And what I came to realization was that later down the line was that you can't make everybody happy. And in any industry that you're in, you will never satisfy everybody. You're gonna always have someone that's not satisfied. So never think that you're gonna satisfy, you're gonna make everybody happy. I have had clients that will do a whole bunch of unbelievable things that you will never imagine, but it's business, it's gonna happen. But one of my biggest things that I tell people is to keep going. You know what I'm saying? Because I had moments where I would go into a dark place when one thing didn't go right in my business. I would just like go into a dark place. But then over the years, I learned that don't get discouraged. Keep going, because you're going to run into some good people and you're going to run into some bad people. But the number one thing that you have to focus on is being consistent. Stay consistent with what you do and keep pushing, even on your bad days. You know, you doing it. You know, you're doing everything right in your business. You're you know, you're staying consistent, you're doing everything, and then boom, you have someone who gets on social media and say whatever, then you have someone that gets on there and file a dispute, you know, things that just happen in business in general. But you have to understand that you have to keep going, you know what I'm saying, and keep going no matter what. And that was something that I feared. I went in dark places about, because I always had this standard for myself that I always wanted to be the best at what I do and what I offer to people. I always wanted to be the person who made people happy. And that goes back to when I say I always wanted to be the best, that goes back to me saying that I'm the creme de la creme. So I'll let you guys Google what the creme de la creme mean. And I've always called myself the creme de la creme, because no matter what I've done, no matter what I've did in this lifetime, I always ensured that I would be the best at what I do, and always be the best out of everyone. And that's just me, and that's how everyone should feel and think about themselves. So those is one of my fears, and I learned to overcome it. When you run into so many different clients, and in the end, the good always outweighed the bad, you know what I'm saying? Because I was young, I'm not perfect, I'm learning from experience, and sometimes everybody don't understand it. They expect so much out of you, which is absolutely fine. Okay, so that was one question. What is the best business moment you had in your business? So one of the best business moments that I had in my business was, I don't know, like, because I've always been super excited about everything, because I found myself, when I started selling hair, I found myself getting into modeling. Like, it's so many doors that open up to you when being an entrepreneur. So many doors open up to you, and I think that was one of my best business moments of my life, because when I got into selling hair, I found myself doing everything that I always wanted to do, which was I love taking pictures, wearing makeup, doing my hair more often. All those things was important to me, and it was just so wonderful for me because I actually got to do those things. And it just made me happy. It was like one of the best moments in my business. I connected with so many people. I networked with so many people getting into this business. I've done a lot of exciting things. So yeah. Y'all, this kind of makes me like emotional, because I've been on a journey. It's 2020 now, and I've been selling hair since 2016. And not just selling hair, I've been selling lashes. I've been an entrepreneur since 2016. I've had some good moments, I had some bad moments, and the good always outweighs the bad. So yeah. Do you save more money making wigs yourself versus ordering them already made? I'll just answer that question. Of course you make more money and you save more money when you just buy the hair and make the wigs yourself. Sometimes the fees can be a little bit more expensive when ordered from your wholesaler. It just depends on what your wholesaler is selling for, but it do save you time. I would recommend just getting them already made, you know, because it saves time. And yeah, it just saves time. You know, sometimes the money is not even worth it. Like, time is everything. So yeah. When will you start taking hair appointments? So right now I'm currently still enrolled into Paul Mitchell. I had a little delay after I had my baby. I took a break on school. My school recommended that I take a break and come back to school. And when life happens and things happen in your life, sometimes you take a different route. And at the time I was just sitting at school, wasn't really for me. I needed to focus, get my energy onto my business. And I started school literally a week after I graduated high school. So for me, I never got a chance to have that little break and kind of figure myself out. And for those who are young entrepreneurs that's in school like I was, my biggest thing for me was my family was like straight by the book. They wanted me to go to school, they wanted me to go to college. They felt like I would be more successful and secure than my. everything you're responsible for you. And always do what makes you happy, because you don't want to ever live in this lifetime where you're suffering trying to make someone else happy that you don't even, you're not even happy with yourself. And that's why so many people who's pressured into going to college, they get in college and they figure that college is not even for them, and then they later drop out, you know. And we don't, like me, you don't want to move backwards. You don't ever want to go backwards. You want to continually to go forward and push. My business is not where it needs to be, but trust me, it has came a long way. I have so much more work to do. I have so much I need to still implant, and it's okay. Things are not going to happen overnight for any of us, you know what I'm saying? You have to put in the work, you have to put in the time, and you have to put in the effort. Overall, just stay consistent with what you do, stay dedicated, stay motivated, stay encouraged, stay empowered. Love yourself, love the people and the things around you. So that's like one of my biggest cues for the girls out there who's watching, the girls out there who's thinking about starting your own business. Ain't nothing wrong with entrepreneurship. Do whatever you want to do. There's room for everyone. There's money to be made for everyone. You can never sell to every single person in America or in this country, period. It's so many people out here that you can be connected with. So always remember that. And I'm also taking my own advice this year as well, because this year we're gonna stoop it up a notch, y'all. And just remember that you're gonna always need a team. And I was that girl who felt like I didn't need a team, that I could do it all by myself, that I'm, you know, I had a big head, you know. But you're gonna need a team, you guys. Gather you a team, get you a team together that's trustworthy. That's the biggest thing. Is everyone needs a team, but it's so hard finding the right team. And sometimes what I've learned, what I just recently learned, is that you can have the team, but sometimes the coach can take that big effect on the team players. You feel me? Like, the coach can take a big effect on the team. So be mindful with who you are and what you bring to the table and what do you allow. So that was another big thing for me, was building a team. We all need a team, you guys. It's not afraid. Everyone needs help, but you have to find the right help. Take your time with it. And yeah, so that's my advice on that. I didn't even answer the question. I feel bad. So I won't start taking hair appointments. I'm just kind of unsure on what I want to do at the moment. I'm actually enrolled in school to be a salon owner, not a hairstylist, but I feel like over time I will get into being a hairstylist, and when I do, I will take hair appointments. If you ever need your hair done, I am welcoming you with warm. Seriously, I'm welcoming you guys in to come in, contact me, and I will service you. I will never turn any type of service down. I will always service you. So feel free to contact me if you need any type of service from me, whether it's hair, makeup, anything. I'm gonna be doing it. Okay. All these questions I'm not gonna answer, y'all, because I just feel like they're illiterate and they're not worthy of answering at the moment. So yes, guys, I kind of hope that I kind of went into detail with everything. As far as my business, business is going good per usual. I don't really post as much, and those is one of the questions. Why don't you always post like you used to? And to answer that, I kind of, over time, I learned the industry of social media, and I just kind of wanted to take a break from it. And when I took my break, I just got in the habit of not posting as much of my personal life, because if you know me, like, back then I used to post every single thing. But I try to stay off social media as much as I can, and kind of stay private as much as I can. because social media is just so powerful. If you don't know how to use it correctly, it can destroy you. So I'm just very sure of that when using it. So yes, guys, I hope I answered all you guys' questions. And if you have any more business related questions, comment below in the comment section and I will make a part two to this video. So yes guys, and I just know, I don't know what you guys' New Year's resolution is, but my New Year's resolution is to just fucking do what the fuck makes me happy. And I just hate to kind of get so verbal, but just to live in my truth, do what makes me happy, and stay consistent with whatever I do, and just consistently push and move forward to be better than I was yesterday. And I feel like if you just have that, everything else will follow. I'm not really concerned financially wise. Of course, we all finna turn the notch up, get the bag. But if your mental is not there, nothing else will be there, not even financially. So that's my biggest thing, just to be mentally there. So yes guys, thank you guys so much for taking the time out to watch my vlog. I will have a part two to this, but your girl gotta get on the road, y'all. I'm about to go get on the road and I have to go pick up my baby. So I'm gonna see y'all in the next video. Love y'all. Thank y'all guys so much for watching, and I hope to see you guys again soon. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. I'm in love, eh? But yes, I'm about to go, and I'll catch up with you guys next time. And don't forget to follow your girl on Instagram at realiscamry. And I'm gonna actually do another questionnaire from my Instagram. We'll go from there. And yes guys, love y'all. See y'all next time.